Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with our look at today's stock market. It's a Veterans Day in the U.S., Remembrance Day in Canada, and so far things are fairly quiet this morning. Stock index futures are slightly above fair value, while commodities are down again this morning. So not much of a change in the pre-market outlook. Let's start off this morning looking at our commodity ETFs. We don't have anything new to report this morning, no trend changes. Our commodity tracking ETF is still on a sell signal, traded into the channel yesterday, but ended the day lower on the day. Copper still on a sell signal, no change there. Big reversal for gold. It was up sharply on Friday, down sharply on Monday, still holding last week's low. Platinum still down, holding last week's low. Similar situation for silver, has not taken out last week's low. So that's a positive sign for the precious metals. Crude oil traded into the channel for the last couple of days, but still on a sell signal, no change there. We'd need to close above $30.42 on Tuesday to give us a buy signal. Not expecting that to happen. Gasoline traded through the upper channel line yesterday, but actually closed lower on the day, so no change there. And there's a natural gas looking like it might have peaked. If you had an order in at $23.44, that got filled. So far, we're not near a sell signal, still trading above the upper channel line, but we may have peaked on Friday, and we'll have to see if we get fall through to the downside on Tuesday. Next up, let's take a look at stocks, bonds, and currencies. Starting off, looking at the VIX continues to move lower. That, of course, is supportive for higher stock prices. We've come down to the 1250 level. We've also come down to fill an open gap here. So we'll have to see how the market reacts to this filling of the open gap. I want you to start thinking about buying the VIX again. Remember, we did this earlier in the year. We bought a chunk of the VIX over a couple of weeks, accumulated a position, and then held that position until we had a nice big pop in the VIX. Most of you made between 50 and 100% on that trade, and I'll let you know when I'm starting to build a position in the VIX, but it's going to start over the next couple of days and last a couple of weeks. There's the VIX for the NASDAQ, continue to move lower. Again, we have an open gap there that we're dealing with, and we're coming down to see if that gap actually acts as support or if the market decides to trade through it. And of course, you can see that the VIX for the NASDAQ traded much lower than where we are right now, and we'll have to see if that is the ultimate goal. Unfortunately, the VIX is out of sync with the stock market once again. The stock market is racing ahead of where the VIX thinks it should be. That, of course, is just a divergence, and there's lots of divergences in the market at any one time. None of them mean anything until they do. There is the 30-year bond traded through the upper channel line yesterday, but ended the day lower on the day. There's the total bond market ETF traded into the channel. There's the Canadian iShares bond ETF, inside day yesterday for that ETF. The U.S. dollar traded down to the upper channel line and then ended the day higher on the day. Similar situation for the euro, trading up to the lower channel line but ending lower on the day. Fairly quiet day for the British pound, fairly quiet day for the Japanese yen. And looking at the Canadian dollar, we traded into the channel yesterday but ended the day lower on the day. The global Dow continued to move higher on Monday. We saw some buying in the emerging markets, traded up to the upper channel line. Still need to close above 41.64 to give us a buy signal for the emerging markets ETF. There's the Dow continuing to move higher. The TSX is up above resistance. If we can take out yesterday's high, look for a move up to 15,000. That's our next mathematical target to the upside. There's the S&P 500 trading above 2031, so that is certainly supportive for higher stock prices. There's the NASDAQ trying to break out above the recent high. And then here's where we get into some divergences. We've got the Russell unable to get up above the previous high from late August, and certainly the ultimate high here would be a move up above the June high. So we've got the Russell, the Zacks Microcap, and certainly the Venture Exchange lagging the rest of the market. So that's not that healthy. We had the Venture Exchange trade up to the upper trend line yesterday, but actually closed lower on the day. So no change in trend there. There's U.S. bank stocks. They are trading slightly above the recent September high. There's Canadian bank stocks lagging U.S. bank stocks right now. Credit card stocks holding up, trying to break out above 100. Of course, 103.13 would be a next target to the upside. There is the U.S. Amex Oil and Gas Index. A little pullback yesterday, still on a buy signal from Friday. There's the TSX Energy Index, a little pullback there yesterday as well, still on a buy signal from Friday. We had a slight reversal yesterday for gold stocks. They were up nicely on Friday into the channel. No fall through to the upside on Monday for the XAU or for the TSX Gold Index, having an inside day on Monday. Looking at semiconductors, they had an inside day on Monday as well. And there is the transports continuing to move higher, and that is certainly a sector that has been leading this charge to the upside over the last couple of weeks. Let's finish off this morning's presentation with a quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. There's the VIX down at the bottom of the right-hand corner, currently ranked as zero, with the S&P 500 up at the top right-hand corner. And so at some point, those are going to squeeze together. Don't know when that is going to be. The first sign of a trend change on Tuesday, which I'm not really looking for. It should be fairly quiet, being Remembrance Day and Veterans Day. We're looking for a close above 1305. That's an hourly close on 10:30, 11:30, 12:30, 1:30, 2:30, 3:30. Above that would signal some weakness in the stock market. Looking at the S&P 500, a close below 20.32.19 would give us a new intraday sell signal. For the NASDAQ 100, we're looking for an hourly close below 41.61.93. Looking at the XAU, we're looking for an hourly close above 66.79 to give us an intraday buy signal. Last week we ran up, didn't get anywhere. We got above the 50-hour, but not above the 100-hour, and certainly not above the 200-hour moving average. Looking at the TSX, an hourly close below 14,665 would give us an intraday sell signal on Tuesday. Looking up, our next target to the upside is 14,843. Remember, this is the range that we were trading in, down here at 14,375. And then up here, we started to break out above that range. Really need to close above this high to tell us that something new is actually happening here. Otherwise, we look like we're still stuck to that area of resistance. So 14,843 is our next target. And if we take that out, then 15,000. So look, two lines up to 15,000. That's our ultimate target. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. It should be a fairly quiet day for obvious reasons. Veterans Day in the U.S., Remembrance Day in Canada. So not expecting a lot of volatility on Tuesday. Thank you very much for your time, and we'll be back a little later this morning looking at the 10 most actively traded NASDAQ stocks from Monday's trading action.